Welcome to the English class. Today we will study pronouns part 3. Part 1 and part 2 already we have studied. And in this part we will study reflexive and emphatic pronouns and distributive pronouns and then reciprocal pronouns. We will see it one by one. We need to understand it one by one. See here. See it properly, read it properly and then you will understand. Reflexive and emphatic pronouns. Words such as here you see myself, ourselves, yourselves, himself, herself, and then here again you see themselves are cold reflexive pronouns. Let us understand it with definition. When the words are used to refer back to the subject of the sentence, then it is only reflexive pronouns. But when it is used for the sake of the emphasis, then it is emphatic pronouns. An emphatic pronoun is used immediately after noun or pronoun. Let us see difference between reflexive and emphatic pronoun. Here you see in this sentence, I can do it myself. You see here, I can do it myself. Let us read the first line. When the words are used to refer back to the subject of the sentence, then it is only reflexive pronouns. And therefore it is reflexive pronouns. Here I itself is myself. Myself itself is I. And therefore, I is subject and myself is referring to subject. And thus, it is only reflexive pronouns. And when we see I myself, and here we are giving emphasis, I myself. And therefore, read the next line, that is, but when it is used for the sake of the emphasis, then it is emphatic pronoun. And it is used immediately after subject. Hope this is a subject, I, and this is myself pronoun. And here this myself is a reflexive pronoun. Here myself is a what called emphatic pronoun. Let's go and see the next one. Here you see distributive pronouns. Right from your childhood you might have studied what this distributive. Let us see. Are those pronouns which replace a noun individually. Okay, let's read once more. From here we have to read. Distributive pronouns. Are those pronouns which replace a noun individually. It is replacing noun individually. Let us see how. We have example and then you will understand. Here we have each and then it and then either and then neither word is here and then every word is here. Look at here. This sentence. Each one is expensive to buy. There are too many maybe pens are kept over there. But you find that each one is expensive to buy. Next example you see. Either of them is interesting to read. Either of them is. There are too many books. But you are not feeling getting any interest to read. So, too many books, but not a single book is good for you. So, this sentence means either of them is interesting to read. Let us go to the third example. Neither of them is easy to learn. Maybe it is too hard. Mathematics is too hard for you. And there are too many mathematics to be solved. So, for you it is, there are too many mathematics, maybe 10, maybe 5, maybe 7. And neither of the mathematics for you is very easy. So last example, you see, everyone is expected to be on time. Everyone means whole school are there, but individually we are pointing here that everyone is expected to be on time. So this is distributive pronouns. Let's go to the last one, that is reciprocal pronouns. When we say reciprocal pronoun, then it is something difficult. We find what is it. Let us understand it. We receive each other. It is something like that. Read this pink box, you will find it. When we use one of the reciprocal pronouns, it means two or more people do the same thing. Same thing they are doing, not single. For example, Susan and Rebecca recognized each other. So both of them can recognize each other. And now you see, Susan recognized Rebecca and Rebecca recognized Susan. Let us see this side here. What is this? Each other and then one another. We do not use us or ourselves instead of reciprocal pronouns. So here I have written, we look at us. No, this is wrong. Let us come down. We do not use reciprocal pronouns as plural form. What we do not do? Each other, we don't use. So let us go ahead again. One another for more than two people. Here you see, Asian ethnicities distinguish from one another. So here more than one people are there. In second line you will see, the kids are playing with one another outside. Okay, here you see kids. Here kids describe that students are more than one or more than two. And down you see, each for two people. We are using each for two people. Look at here. We need to trust each other. We need to trust each other. So this is only between two people. One another is more than two. And each is used for two people, between two. So example, you see here, we trust each other for two people. And down you see, she and I had sat next to each other. So here one person is she and then one is I. They are just sitting next to each other. Hope you will understand it better way. Read it again and again. Listen it again and again. Thank you. And here our chapter pronouns ends.